Hello and welcome to Dr. X's News. Recently, after an inter-ministerial meeting, the Health Ministry has dismissed the Prohibition of Violence and Damage to Property Bill 2019, which seeks to punish people who assault on-duty doctors and other healthcare professionals, stating that there cannot be separate legislation to check violence against the members of any specific profession. The health minister added that the government is concerned about the rise of incidences of assault on doctors and soon a central law will be implemented to curb the assaults. The bill was approved earlier during the winter session of the parliament in 2019. Recently, the US FDA has approved two generic versions of apixaban, which is used to reduce the risk of stroke and systemic embolism in patients with non-valvular atrial fibrillation. The oral anticoagulant is also indicated for the prophylaxis of deep vein thrombosis and pulmonary embolism. Apixaban is not recommended for patients with prosthetic heart valves and atrial fibrillation that is caused by a heart valve problem. The US FDA mentions that the generic approval would provide low-cost, safe and high-efficacy medicines. The US FDA has approved trastuzumab deruxtecan for the treatment of patients with unresectable or metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer. The approved drug has also been positively granted for those who have received two or more prior anti-HER2-based regimens in the metastatic setting. The drug is a combination of HER2-directed antibody and topoisomerase inhibitor conjugate, which is a chemical compound that is toxic to cancer cells. Scientists from the Scripps research team have engineered a special molecular mechanism that enables clinicians to control dosing in gene therapies. The mechanism is said to be the first practical way to adjust therapeutic gene expression. Scientists have demonstrated that the incorporation of the new switching technique produces the erythropoietin hormone that can be used as a treatment for anemia. Additionally, the special embedded molecule made it possible to suppress gene expression at low concentrations and improve the gene expression using morpholinos. The simplicity of the technique and the FDA approval of morpholinos allows the use of the switching device in a wide range of gene therapies. According to a report published by the British Association of Perinatal Medicine, three babies are treated for opioid addiction nearly every day. The drastic increase in the number of children born addicted is attributed to the rise in opioid addiction and prescribing opioid drugs for pain relief during pregnancy. The newborns with illicit drug addiction show various short-term symptoms such as high-pitched continuous crying, fits, fever, vomiting, diarrhea, and sweating. Addiction at a young age is also associated with long-term problems such as slow development, visual impairment, and learning difficulties. The association has reported it as an alarming sign for opioid outburst in the UK and has suggested close monitoring of the problem during pregnancy and postpartum. These were the latest happenings in the medical field brought to you by DocPixels, the global online community of doctors. Stay tuned for more every Thursday at 6 p.m. Happy DocPixing!